your heart, no, baby, my heart beat than it you. Ooh, ooh, that's just what I do, do, do. And that's just how we do it, do it, do it. Yeah, that's just how we do it, do it, do it. You like it, what I do, do. Hello, everyone. This is Mary Joy Iriagudo, and welcome to my first tour at L-Time. Stay tuned and let's learn together. And for today's discussion, we will be talking about the integrating ecological literacy into the curriculum and the outer and inner ecological perspectives. So at this point, let us now proceed to the integrating of ecological literacy into the curriculum. But before proceeding, let us first define what is ecological literacy. So, ecological literacy is the ability to understand the natural systems that make life on Earth possible. So, it is to be eco-literate, meaning it is to understand the principles of organization of ecological communities and using those principles for creating sustainable human communities.
Integrating ecological literacy into the curriculum. So before we proceed to the two ecological perspectives, which are inner and outer, let us first define what is ecological perspectives. So it is a useful framework for understanding the range of factors that influence health and well-being.
So inner ecology includes the mind, emotion, and spirit. It is when we make the time to explore and nurture our inner landscape, cultivate our inner terrain. Some of the many dividends include peace of mind, a healthier physical body, and inner wealth. So at the lower part are some practical suggestions for how you can support the change for sustainability via ecological living. So I pick three. These are becoming a catalyst for the changes that are needed to help co-create a better world and future. You are part of the web of life. And lastly, make the most of our sustainability crisis. So next is the outer ecology. So the environment beyond inside, marked outside, the boundary either real or virtual, with indefinite areas are called as the outer environment. The outer side of the body remains the contrast to the temperature of the outside, constituting the outer environment. So at the lower part again are some practical suggestions. So I pick three. These are educate yourself about the resources that you, your family, and organization utilize to fulfill and sustain your needs. Second, reduce, reuse, repurpose, and recycle. Third, support local businesses and organizations that care for our planet.
At this moment, we will now proceed to the next discussion, which is the integrating of ecological literacy into the curriculum. But before anything else, we will first define what is ecological literacy. So, ecological literacy is a basic life skill that every human being on our planet should be supported to develop and is part of our personal development. But in science, ecology is about the relationships between organisms and their natural environment.
Integrating ecological literacy into the curriculum. The Center for Ecoliteracy promotes a variety of teaching strategies based on practices matched to students' levels of development and on brain-based research to foster the knowledge, skills, and values essential to sustainable living. We recognize that students learn best when teaching strategies are varied to include hands-on activities, time for reflection, and thoughtful discussion. A mix of indoor and outdoor environments and opportunities to participate in interdisciplinary projects.
Let us proceed now to the first learning concept, which is the place-based learning.
Place-based education is an approach that connects learning and communities with the primary goals of increasing student engagement, boosting academic outcomes, impacting communities, and promoting understanding of the world around us. These benefits can impact students, teachers, families, communities, and society.
According to our research, here are some of the benefits of a place-based learning. First is a higher test scores, better grade point averages, improved classroom behavior, increased self-esteem and problem-solving skills, and higher level thinking skills.
So let us now proceed to the next learning concept, which is the project-based learning. So it is a teaching method in which students gain knowledge and skills by working for an extended period of time to investigate and respond to an authentic, engaging, and complex question, problem, or challenge. While many teachers involve students in projects after exposing them to traditional instruction, project-based learning is not an extension or add-on but is central to the curriculum. Based on challenging questions requiring complex thinking and skills, project-based learning is often interdisciplinary.
Projects vary in length from a couple of weeks to an entire school year and require students to use a variety of resources, including the community, technology, outside experts, written resources, and the web, as well as each other. Rather than being the expert, the teacher acts as a facilitator to learning.
Next learning concept is Socratic inquiry. Socratic inquiry is named for the Greek philosopher Socrates, who believed that questions, not answers, stimulate learning. Rather than teaching facts and information, Socrates encouraged young people to question their assumptions, values, and preconceptions. Through this process, students uncover their beliefs, misconceptions, and values, and eventually clarify their thoughts related to the topic under discussion.
Through engaging in Socratic discussions, students can become more adept at critical thinking, improve their listening skills, learn to better articulate their thoughts and ideas, and become more tolerant of diverse opinions. In Socratic inquiry, the role of the teacher shifts from direct instruction to facilitating discussion. Through skilled questioning, the teacher asks students to clarify their statements, identify weakness in their arguments, and provide evidence for their reasoning.
Next learning concept is experiential learning. Grounded in the work of John Dewey and Jean Piaget, experiential learning recognizes that learning is an active process. Traditional schooling views the teacher and text as experts and the learners as a passive recipient of that expertise. By contrast, experiential learning promotes involvement in the real world and defines the teacher's role as a facilitator of learning. The process of learning takes precedence over the behavioral outcomes and is based on the premise that learning is a continuous process with experience at its foundation. And the last learning concept is the interdisciplinary learning. So it emphasizes connections between traditionally discrete disciplines such as math, science, history, and language arts rather than limiting learning to one content area at a time. When teaching and learning are organized around themes, problems, or issues, students seek knowledge and skills from a variety of disciplines to provide expanded and more complex understanding of the topics they are studying.